really creepy. Look at that.
Welcome, fellow travelers. Your traveling buddy here, coming to you today from Lansing, Michigan. And I come to you from Old Town area here, and I come to you at the Dodge Turner House right here. So, very famous Victorian building that's here. It's supposed to be very haunted, but today they're having an event today called Victorian Halloween. They're going to show how Halloween was back in the Victorian days. So, figured to come check this out. So, travel with me, will you? Like I said, this is a very famous historical building here. And here's a historical marker out front here. It's called the Turner Dodge House. James Turner, a Lansing pioneer, originally owned this property. A native of New York, Turner came to Lansing in 1847. From nearby Mason, where he was a merchant, he immediately opened a general store in the Seymour House, the first hotel in North Lansing. He was appointed deputy state treasurer in 1860 and elected the state senate in 1866. Interested in education, he helped founded the Mrs. Rogers Seminary, later called the Michigan Female College, 1855 to 1869, which is the Abigail, which I've done a video on that one. He was also active in the construction of plank roads and railroads in the Lansing area. Frank L. Dodge married Turner's daughter, Abby, in 1888 and purchased this house from Turner's widow in 1899. Dodge, a Democrat, was elected to the state legislature in 1883 and 1885. He was city alderman for 12 years and was active on several civic boards. Like I said, that college he's talked about is the Abigail over here. Which later became the blind school where Stevie Wonder went. And I've actually did a video there. And they're trying to restore that building. On the other side of this marker, it says Turner Dodge House, gracefully situated high on the banks of the Grand River. This classical rival state mansion, built in 1858, was the home of prominent Lansing merchant James Turner, 1820 to 1869. In 1899, Turner's son-in-law, Frank L. Dodge, 1853 to 1929, bought and enlarged it. The three-story building was designed by Lansing architect Darius Noon. Features Stanley wooden Ionic columns and the decorative currents in its interior, with its large classical doorways and several fireplaces. This Dodorn was believed beveled and leaded French windows. After remaining in the family for a century, the property was purchased by the Great Lakes Bible College in 1858. In 1974, the city of Lansing acquired it for a park. The site was listed on the Historical National Register of Historical Places in 1972, which is the year I was born. That's cool. We are inside the Dodge Turner house. There's some pictures of Frank L. Dodge. Look at this Halloween costume here. Victorian Halloween costume. That's cool. Just talking to the gentleman here, and he's giving me more information. He says this is what the house originally looked like when they first built it, and then his son-in-law or his daughter built it to look like this. Definitely a lot different. And then look at these Halloween pictures. I never knew they had this technology back then. Look at those are fake, but. Look at that woman's head's floating above her body, and this one, this guy's holding the head. Look at that. I just recently really learned that they had the technology to do that stuff back then. That is cool.
House sort of underneath things where this hutch would have been a bedroom door back when it was the 1800s. And they turned it into a hutch when they turned it into a dining room.
Oh, wow.
So there would have been probably a wall down the middle here, and this would have been two bedrooms.
This used to be two bedrooms. That's interesting. Well, yeah, if you look at that picture, right, this would be the area where that extension would come out.
Yep. So then the butler's pantry and the new kitchen got added on in Frank's time.
Here's a picture of their original house, which he's told me where it's at. There's actually an ice cream shop that's on the property now. But that was their original house before they moved here. That's cool.
I think there is a, some sort of stone.
Look at this fireplace here with cobwebs on it. There's some more of those creepy pictures.
So, to rent the entire house, it's $145 per hour, with a minimum of 3 hours. But then,
wow, that is creepy.
For a non-Lansing resident, it's $160 per hour. Usually we have like a $1,000 deposit, proof of liability insurance.
So those are actual pictures from back in the day. That is so weird.
If it's like a wedding or something like that, you can do a rehearsal time blocked off too.
Here we have one of Abigail Turner's dress right here. That's weird. I mean, pretty cool actually. And that's, that's Queen Victoria. There's another picture of Dr. Turner. Oh, check this out. I got an actual old wicker casket here. What was spirits on? Piano. Oscar Ralph, Abby R. Turner's music instructor. Oh wow, that was her music instructor. Look at this wedding dress right here. I wonder why they got her face in the window. Look at that train. Picture of Abby Turner. That was his wife. There's Frank Turner. Frank Dodge, I mean. Marion Turner. Yeah, we're gonna go upstairs. It's a beautiful place. A picture of the Dodge Turner house, and this is when they looks like they first building it. Oh, that's when they were renovating it, building it to what it looks like now. Creepy clown. That's cool. That's funny. We got a picture of Pennywise here. That's it right there. It does remind you of Pennywise. Look at these. Pretty cool. Oh, look at the old Halloween mask here. Here you go, people. Anybody that's afraid of clowns, look at that creepy face. I can see where some people would be afraid of clowns. That's kind of scared me. I was looking around, turned the corner, and saw this mannequin sitting in his chair with his mask. I startled me real quick. I was like, that's pretty cool. They ever do any night tours here? Said this place is supposedly haunted. Oh, look at this old wedding dress. Little dolls. This in here. So also in the kids' room, look at these creepy little dolls here moving. Oh, they're cool. They look like they're from like one of the old storage display things. It's kind of creepy. They got this sitting right in the middle of the floor here. There's a little doll here. I was waiting for it to move. Oh, it's really creepy. Look at that. Another bedroom here. Look at this. Clothes hanging out. Skull. Oh, look at this. Something. I've heard of people doing that. Be buried with their loved one side by side. can see, she was already gone quite a while ago. Wow, that's creepy. Well, a woman in a casket. I don't do that too much anymore. They used to do that way back. Take pictures of the loved one before they buried them. Dead or alive. Just turning over for answer. Dead. So the genuine post-mortician photography. Subject is almost lying down, often in a casket or in a bed. I used to take pictures of the people. What's this one? Oh boy, he says dead or alive, turn over for answer. He's alive. Of course, because he's standing up. This is weird. This photo here says, down the bottom says, John O'Connor, taken 2 years after death and 5 days before burial. So, the guy standing in the middle is actually dead. Now that's weird. This looks like it was a mirror and they put a picture of a vampire on there. If you look at it right. That's cool. To the third floor. Oh, look at the Edison Victorial, or what do you want to call it? There's a picture of Edison right there. Now that we're learning more about Edison, it makes you wonder if he actually invented that or not. Find out a lot of these inventions he didn't actually invent. Skeleton up here and a witch's hat. Looks like they have some kind of a show up here. It's like a ballroom, I think. We're in Old Town. You can see across the street there. Look at those old houses over there. Check this out. This is the billiards room. Oh, wow. That one got me. I thought that was a real woman standing there. Look at her. Yeah. That mannequin looks pretty real. You look at her from the distance. I wonder if these were original pillars that were here. So I'm sure they look right there, see? I think these are the original ones and they replaced them. Look at that, it looks pretty similar. These are probably the originals. This is cool. Look at this artwork. The gift of the artist Craig Mitchell Smith. Look at it, it's like a the Dodge Turner house etched onto the glass. I had a guy forgot me. Turned the corner, I was about to go film her again. And I noticed there's a mannequin laying on here under this sleeping bag. Look at that. Kind of startled me. I don't know why they got them laying like that. Look at this woman. Except there's that mannequin again. It's like a Victorian Halloween costume. Alright, fellow travelers, I'm done here touring the Dodge Turner house. That was great fun. You know, those people are real nice in there. I told them I'd put their Facebook information down in my video and all that for you. If you guys want to check them out, you know, you ever get down here to Lansing, come here, Turner, tour the Dodge Turner house. It's only about $5 to get in. You know, you can tour the whole place or you can take a guided tour, you know. They have all kinds of activities going on here. Right now they're doing the Halloween. Now next they're going to do a Christmas thing. Do all kinds of themes. It's all to raise money to keep this place going. So if you like this, hit that like button. Share, subscribe. Any comments for me, leave me a comment. Any comments, appreciate it. Any ideas for me to do, let me know. I just might show up and do it. So until next time, travelers. I'll see you around the mitten.
Mm-hmm.